Back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my makeup storage. I'm going to show you how I organize my makeup, what containers I use, and how I like to place everything so that my makeup is accessible to me and how I'm able to see everything so I can utilize it. This is my vanity table. It's called the Mom Vanity Table. I purchased it from IKEA. I'm pretty sure you guys know about this or have seen it because it's a very, very popular vanity. Absolutely love how it has a glass top because it's so much easier cleaning up makeup off of a glass surface rather than just a white vanity tabletop because that will just completely get ruined. I highly suggest getting a vanity table that has a glass protector over it, or if not, you can definitely go get one custom made at any glass customizing store. The makeup mirror I use is from the brand Zadro. I'm going to link down below my complete review on the makeup mirror in case you guys are interested in checking it out. Starting first with the vanity drawer, and in here I like to keep things that I use on a daily basis. I like to place my makeup removers, moisturizers, toners, any types of oils for the face, and any blemish control items. I keep them all in this drawer. A lot of these clear containers are from, this one's from the Dollar Spot at Target. I believe this one is from Daiso, $1.50. So I always make sure to keep an eye out for any really inexpensive clear storage drawers. Now in the very back, I have this other container. And this one is from Target. I just keep my kabuki brushes and any other brushes that I'm not using. In this square container, I just keep my little bow palette for mixing any foundation or concealer. And then if I have any dirty blending sponges, I just keep it in this container. All the way back here in this corner, I just keep some of my contact lenses, colored contact lenses for fun, you know, for filming. So I'm gonna start from left to right. And we're first gonna start with this 7-drawer clear acrylic storage or cosmetic storage container. I'm going to link them down below if you guys are interested. So the unique thing about this is that the drawers are actually customizable. The first 4 top drawers are customizable. It includes some inserts so you can divide each of the trays into little sections. This container is very durable, it's really sturdy. The only thing I'm gonna say about this is that the drawers get stuck sometimes. They don't really glide smoothly when you push them back in, so that's my only complaint about it. But I like the way how they have knobs to kind of pull out the drawers. So in this first drawer, I just keep a lot of my black eyeliners, whether they're gel, pencil, and I also have some colorful ones up here which just didn't fit anywhere else, so I place them in here. In the next 3 bottom drawers, I just store my higher end lip products. The bottom 3 drawers are a little bit larger, so in this one I like to keep a lot of my lip balms or just lip exfoliants. Here I like to keep my brow products and just some lipsticks which did not fit in any of the other drawers. And this very last drawer is dedicated to any makeup tutorials that I film. I like to place all of the items that I used in that makeup tutorial in this drawer so that it's easy to refer back when I'm editing the video, or if I need to take like an up close video or an up close shot of that product. At least all of the items are just in this drawer. Right next to it, I have another clear acrylic storage container which I purchased from the Muji store. And this one has 4 rectangular pull out drawers, which is really nice. It's really great because I can store in here my eyeliners, which is what I primarily store in here. In the next drawer, I just keep some of my most used eyeshadow bases. And lastly, we have all of my lip liners. Right on top of that, I have a Hello Kitty brush holder, which my sister-in-law, they gave this to me a few years ago. And I am a huge Hello Kitty fan, as you guys know. Right next to her, I have a depotted Bath & Body Works jar, which I then just filled with Q-tips and some cotton rounds, which I use every single day, so it had to be right in front of me. And I just glued this Hello Kitty, I think it was a roller ball. This was the top of the roller ball. I just super glued it to the top of the lid. And then I have some makeup brushes. The containers, these 2 containers are from Target, from the Sonia Kashuk line. And this one I received from Generation Beauty the other year, I believe from London Soho. Now for the rest of my brushes, I store them in this white lace-like container, which is from the Dollar Spot at Target. And I divided them into different groups. So these are for the eyes, these are for like powders and foundations. And I store them on top of this clear turntable, which is also from Target. I believe you get this in the bathroom area. but it makes it so much easier to find a brush because you just turn it around instead of having like to dig all the way in the back. You can just turn the turntable, which is getting stuck on my curtain right now. For my lip glosses and some lipsticks that I like to display, I keep them in this clear acrylic container, which is from the brand By Allegory. I'm going to link my full review on these storage containers in the down bar below. They're really good, high quality. I believe they're available in a couple other different colors. Now for the rest of my lip products, which are mostly drugstore, I like to keep them on the right side of my vanity. Here I like to store them in these clear acrylic drawers from the Muji store. So these are actually two separate ones. These are the two drawers which are a little bit wider. And then we have the five drawer which are perfect just for single lipsticks. Right in front of the drawers I have this plate which I got from Bath & Body Works, and I just like to place any new makeup that I'm testing out for the week on this plate, so at least I can see it and I'll remember to use it. As for my vanity chair, this is from IKEA. It's called the Skruvska swivel chair. It's super comfortable because it also has a cushion at the bottom. The chair is a little bit bulky, but I think it works with the mom vanity. Now as for the rest of my makeup, I have it stored in these two Alex drawers, which are also from IKEA, and these have 9 drawers. At the very top of my two Alex drawers, I have my jewelry, which I have a whole video on my jewelry storage. I'm going to link it here in the video and also down below in the description box. Make sure you guys go check that out if you're interested in how I store my jewelry. I'm gonna film my Alex drawers a little bit differently from my point of view when I'm sitting down and looking at the makeup when I'm sitting in my makeup chair. So in this first drawer, I just keep a lot of my face primers, eye primers, and my concealers, and just some blotting sheets. And all of these storage containers are also from Daiso Japan, only $1.50. In the next Alex drawer, I just keep a lot of my makeup bags so that it's easy for me just to grab it when I'm on the go, and it's all right here, very accessible. Each of the drawers are lined with this clear plastic shelf lining, which I also purchased from IKEA. And these I had to just kind of cut them to the size of each of the drawers. I actually need to get another roll. So I would say 4 rolls should be enough for 2 Alex drawers, or just 2 of the rolls for 1 Alex drawer. Next we have foundations, BB creams, and CC creams. And these containers are also from the Dollar Spot at Target, and this one is from Daiso Japan. In here I store all of my powders and also highlighters, as well as smaller highlighters, liquid highlighters in that container. The next drawer contains all of my blushes, and these containers right here, they're from the Dollar Tree. It was my girl Vina May on YouTube. I'm gonna link her channel down below. She had mentioned these on Snapchat. I went out and purchased them. They're really good clear storage containers. They're actually for utensils, so not bad for a dollar. The next drawer over, I just store all of my larger blush palettes and some of my single blushes. This next drawer is dedicated to bronzers and contour palettes, and I have all of my round single bronzers stored in this clear acrylic storage container from the brand By Allegory. The next drawer over, I store a lot of my single eyeshadows and some eyeshadow bases. This container right here is from the brand By Allegory. It's pretty nice because you can store 2 of these single Milani eyeshadows. You can store them this way so they're kind of leaning, or you can store them by laying them flat. For the rest of the eyeshadows, I just have them in this Dollar Tree storage container. For my Maybelline color tattoos, I have them in this Daiso container, $1.50. They fit perfectly. It works, you know, I'm able to see everything. Next are all of my larger eyeshadow palettes. This drawer stores all of my smaller eyeshadow palettes. This is definitely one of my favorite drawers because it has all of my false lashes and also mascara and eyelash curlers. This drawer just stores a lot of my hair products, hair brushes, and some heat tools. In this drawer, I keep all the products that I need to test out, or if I have backups of products, I keep them all in here. It's not very organized. I just kind of throw them all in here and just dig through them when I need to. This drawer just stores some heat tools that I haven't tried out yet and some hair extensions. The very bottom drawer are for all of my nail polishes. And this very last drawer is kind of just like my dump drawer. I just store a lot of things in here, like nail files, nail cutters, some nail supplies, stuff for my candles, just a whole bunch of random things. I just put them in this drawer. So I also wanted to show you how I store my hair care products and some lotions, just some other toiletries that are stored underneath the mom vanity. So for a lot of my hair care products, I have them stored on this shelf. They're called the Ripa Picture Ledge. They're really supposed to be for pictures, but they're perfect for hair care products, lotions. It's the perfect size, and I got the smaller one. So I just connected two of them, which are not exactly level, but you know, it works. So if you're gonna install this, this is how it will look underneath the mom vanity. On this side, I just have some of my dry shampoos, lotions, and deodorants. On the left side, I keep more of my lotions, some self-tanner products, and other products that I'm currently testing out. And those are sitting on top of this clear foldable, it's a shelf helper, which I purchased from Home Goods. Under the shelf, I have this Pond's container, which holds all of my hair goods. And underneath that, I have a Divergent makeup box where I like to store a lot of the boxes of products that I'm currently testing out. And then on the right side, I have my Hello Kitty trash can. Right next to it is a container for all of my dirty brushes. I believe I purchased that from Target from the dollar spot, and you can write on it with chalk. And that's sitting on top of another one of those clear foldable shelf helpers, which I purchased from Home Goods. So I hope you guys enjoyed my makeup storage and how I organize everything. If you guys have any questions, please don't forget to leave it in the comment area down below. And also make sure you guys check the description box for links to any of these storage items. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful. And also, please don't forget to subscribe to be notified of new videos. Follow me on all my social media, Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video.